the way up to the big lake, we're going to check out where we had planned to fish for the Derby weekend. We've had some crazy weather in the last 2 days. We had 60 degrees one day and like 2+ inches of rain the day before that, so not sure what we're gonna find. Ty's hooked into our first laker of the morning. First morning of the Derby. We got tip-ups out, we got trout stuff set up, we got everything. And we have not marked anything, and then we marked this one laker and Ty hammered it. Oh, you got him in the side again, man. That's the second one you've done that to. Look at that. That's a good fish. That's dinner right there. The first flag here. Is it spinning? It had to be a fish hit it. There's no wind. Come on, don't blow it, Jeff. Pressure's on. Is he gone? Oh. Oh, that might be a, that's a Derby one right there, buddy. Don't blow it. Ah, there we go. Jeff hooked up on a nice laker.
Alright, so we moved around a bit. We found a spot where kind of a channel dumps in around two islands. We marked probably, I don't know, 8 or 10 lakers in 20 minutes. A lot more activity than we found elsewhere. We caught one laker already here, and this definitely seems like the spot. So we set up camp, we put tip-ups out, set up the shop. About to cook up some deer sausage provided by Jeff.
Alright, doing good. I told you before, we set up in the spot, and we're hammering them. Fish number two. Yeah! He saved it! Oh, he saved it! Alright, oh! Lost it again. Here's the fish that Jeff just saved for Tyler. It's a really nice fish.
Nice fish.
Getting it done. Is that same one that was coming up and down?
Yeah.
Wow, you finally got him, huh?
Finally got him. It was sort of, and actually, he was kind of chasing me quite a bit. I was doing the normal takeaway big sweeps, and then he was sort of just hovering right about a foot off the bottom, and then I just started doing little ones.
Yeah.
As soon as I started doing those little ones, he hammered it.
That's a really light colored fish.
Yeah, it is.
It's a beauty.
Yep.
Different tactic here. We figured we'd try for some rainbows. We're right up on shore, as you can see, only about 5 feet offshore, doing the egg trail trick.
Oh, come on.
That... Fight, let him fight. He's going to work, and then he'll start.
Oh!
Do it again.
That was fat, too. That was a fat rainbow. I think this hook's too little. That or I have to let him just swallow it.
That's one that probably won't come back either.
Oh.
That's how they get to. You get the one shot at a trout like that.
It's 4:30. Day two of the Derby. Getting tired. Made it out on the ice. We're in the shack. We got Liam here with me. Oh, we got all the tip-ups set. Jeff's putting eggs in the trout holes right now. Hopefully, I'm really hoping we run into a trout today. All right. It's been, probably 2 hours now. We've checked the eggs a couple of times for trout, and none of them have been missing. Cooking up food. That's exciting. You see right here. Those are homemade egg, ham, and cheese on English muffins. So, hopefully we get a little more action here soon.
Alright guys, we baiting the holes. We just checked them and found a bunch of eggs missing, almost all the holes. So, we baited this one and we watched the trout come through and hammer them. Hopefully, Jeff will catch us for us here.
Alright, so we're back. Jeff blew it. That's the sum of what happened.
Yep. You
know, hopefully in 30 more minutes, we'll go back over there and we'll have one twice as big so we can miss that one too.
Alright, here we go. Check the holes again.
I'm going to start down here. If you want to ride, you know, take it over by those holes, I'll meet up with you there.
Alright, sounds good.
Alright, so after Jeff missing that fish, we just came back and there's eggs missing. We dropped them down what I think is actually the same hole that Jeff missed the fish in. And I saw him take the eggs. I threw my egg on the hook down there and he ate that. And I gave him a good 3 second count, let him swim outside the hole, set the hook, had him on, and he got off.
So we were just checking the holes when I missed that fish. But I looked back at the four-wheeler and Liam's sitting on the four-wheeler. And he's passed out in the four-wheeler. Bag of chips fell out of his hand and drooling. You got the chips that fell down. Bud, you sleeping? We got to drive back to where the hut is, buddy. Liam, you tired, buddy? You were out like a light. It's a long day fishing, huh? Kids are the best.
We just checked the holes one more time. One hole's missing, and that was it. So we're going to pack everything up and call it a weekend. Never had to say a word. I knew it was too late. That's a lesson I wish I didn't learn the hard way. The hard way. The hard way. The hard way.